Hi everyone. Today in this video we will discuss some problems related to Bernoulli's principle. Already in the last video we discussed what is meant by Bernoulli's principle and different applications of Bernoulli's principle that already covered in the last video. Those who didn't watch that video, first you watch that video, then you go to this video, go through this video. Okay, so we'll discuss with our first question and its solution. Calculate the velocity of emergence of a liquid from a hole inside in the side of a white cell 15 cm below the liquid surface. So here you have to find the velocity with which water is coming through a hole. No. That water is there in some liquid surface, water is there and there is a hole 15 cm below that liquid surface, and you have to find with what velocity water is coming out through this hole. So here you can use Torricelli's law, and we can consider that Torricelli's law of efflux, V is equal to root of 2gh, because atmospheric pressure and the pressure at the topmost surface will be equal. So you can substitute those values. G value is 9.8 and h is 15 centimeters. That is 15 into 10 raised to minus 2. So if you substitute root of 2 into 9.8 into 15 into 10 raised to minus 2. And if you simplify, you will get it as 1.7. And SI unit of velocity is meter per second. So you will get the answer as 1.7 meter per second. Okay. Now we'll discuss the next problem. Water at a gauge pressure of 3.8 atmosphere at street level flows into an office building at a speed of 0.06 meter per second through a pipe 5 centimeter in diameter. The pipes taper down to 2.6 centimeter in diameter by the top floor 20 meter above. Calculate the flow velocity and the gauge pressure in such a pipe on the top floor. Assume no branch pipe and ignore viscosity. Okay, so here all the data given and how to find that we can see. So by applying continuity, equation of continuity, we can write A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2. So V2 can be calculated as A1 V1 by A2. So to find area, cross sectional area, pi r square, diameter is given. So pi into 5 by 2 whole square into velocity at that point, it is given by 0.6 divided by A2, can be written as pi into 2.6 centimeter is the diameter at that position. So 2.6 by 2 whole square. So if you simplify, you will get the velocity as 2.2 meter per second. Then we can apply Bernoulli's principle. P1 plus H1 rho g plus half rho V1 square is equal to P2 plus H2 rho g plus half rho V2 square. And PA, we are writing it as atmospheric pressure. Here all data is given, we can see. So what is the value of P2? P2 is 3.8 into 3.8 Pascal. It is given 3.8 atmospheres. No, 3.8 Pascal. Plus PA plus half rho V1 square minus MG, all those data, rho G H2, rho G H1. So what H1 we can consider at the ground level, no, street level it is given. So height already given. So rho G H minus all those data, if you substitute, you will get it as 2.8 into 10 raised to 5 Pascal. Okay, 2.8 into 10 raised to 5 Pascal. And next question, you can see a horizontal pipe of non-uniform cross-section allows water to flow through it with a velocity of 1 meter per second when pressure is 50 kilopascal at a point. If the velocity of flow has to be 2 meter per second at some other point, what will be the pressure at that point? Okay. So here horizontal pipe is there, so no need of considering that H1 rho g, H2 rho g both will be same because height is same. It is a horizontal pipe. So by applying Bernoulli's principle, actually Bernoulli's principle, we can write P1 plus half rho V1 square plus rho g H1 is equal to P2 plus half rho V2 square plus rho g H2. So P1 is given. What is the value of P1? 50 kilopascal. So 50 into 10 raised to 3. It is not 103. It is 10 raised to 3 plus half into density is given. Density is water. So the half into 1000 into 1. 1 square is 1 itself. Equal to P2. We don't know. Plus half into 1000 into 4. 2 square can be written as 4, and H1 rho g and H2 rho g will be equal because it is horizontal pipe. So if you simplify, you will get it as 50 into 1000 plus 500 minus 2000, which is equal to 48.5 kilopascal. Okay, and now we will discuss the next problem. A dam holds back the water in a lake. If the dam has a small hole 1.4 meters below the surface of the lake, at what speed does water exit the hole? So here also directly we can use that formula root of 2gh, but here step by step it is written. So we can see that P1 plus half rho V1 square plus rho g Y1, that you may be remembering that expression where we derived the expression for Torricelli's law of efflux. There we considered Y1, Y2 are the heights, what height of that from the ground level, to the slit, and to the topmost surface. Okay, so if we are considering P1 plus half rho V1 square plus rho g Y1 equal to P2 plus half rho V2 square plus rho g Y2, and P1 and P2 will be equal to atmospheric pressure. Why? Because surface, the lake is open to atmosphere, so it will be that pressure at the surface of the lake will be equal to atmospheric pressure, and hole is also open to atmosphere, so pressure at the hole also will be equal to atmospheric pressure. So P1 equal to P2 equal to atmospheric pressure, it will get cancelled, and V1 can be taken as zero. So when the water is leaking through the hole, the topmost surface of the lake will be at rest. Velocity at the surface can be assumed to be zero itself. So V1 equal to zero. So we can write it as rho g into Y1 minus Y2 equal to half rho V2 square. And Y1 minus Y2 is 1.4 meters. So V2 can be written as root of 2g into Y1 minus Y2. Or root of 2 into 9.8 into 1.4, and if you simplify you will get it as 5.2 meter per second. So here directly, instead of writing this directly, you can write V2 is equal to root of 2gh and you can find it. Okay, now we'll discuss the next problem. A hose lying on the ground has water coming out of it at a speed of 5.4 meter per second. You lift the nozzle of the hose to a height of 1.3 meters above the ground. At what speed does the water now come out of the hose? Okay, so here water, initially that hose is at the ground level. No, that time the speed is 5.4 meter per second. Now what you are doing, you are lifting that nozzle of the hose to a height 1.3 meters. At that time you have to find what is the speed. So here again we can apply Bernoulli's principle. So P1 plus half rho V1 square plus rho g Y1 equal to P2 plus half rho V2 square plus rho g Y2. Okay. And since the hose is open to atmosphere, P1 equal to P2 is equal to atmospheric pressure, that can be cancelled. Again, we can write half rho V1 square plus rho g Y1 minus rho g Y2 equal to half rho V2 square. We have to find V2. So V2 square is equal to V1 square plus 2g into Y1 minus Y2, or V2 can be written as root of V1 square plus 2g into Y1 minus Y2. V1 is given 5.4. So 5.4 whole square plus 2 into 9.8 into Y1 minus Y2 can be written as minus 1.3. So if you substitute, you will get the answer as 1.9 meter per second. Y1 minus Y2 is minus 1.3. You can check it in the previous video. Okay. And now we will discuss the next problem. The flow of blood in a large artery of an anesthetized The flow of blood in a large artery of an anesthetized dog is diverted through a venturi meter. The wider part of the meter has a cross-sectional area equal to that of the artery, and cross-sectional area is given by 8 millimeter square, and the narrower part has an area which is given by a small a is equal to 4 millimeter square. The pressure drop in the artery is 24 Pascal. What is the speed of the blood in the artery? And given the density of blood is 1.06 into 10 raised to 3 kilogram per meter. So here whichever data given, density of blood is given 1.06 into 10 raised to 3 kilogram per meter cube, and ratio of the areas given 8 millimeter square by 4 millimeter square, that can be written as 2, and we can substitute that value. So already we discussed the expression for velocity, you know, how to find the expression for velocity in the last video we discussed regarding venturi meter. So if you are substituting, we can get v1 is equal to 2h rho mg into a1 square by a2 square minus 1 raised to minus half. So you can substitute all those. So root of 2 into 24 Pascal is there. A1 by density, what density is given? That is, what is the value of density? Density is 1.06 into 10 raised to 3. So if you substitute 1.06 into 10 raised to 3, it is written as 1060. And A1 by A2, it is given. No, that also you can substitute. So what you will get? 2 raised to 2 minus 1. So if you substitute, what you will get? You will get it as 0.125 meter per second. Okay. So if you are having doubt regarding this formula, you can refer the previous video and you can understand and you can solve it. Okay. So like that, similar problems you can solve from your textbook or exercise questions. As many as possible you have to solve it. These few problems only we discussed here. So you can refer varieties of problems from your textbook and you can solve similar problems. And if you are having any doubt, communicate that to me. Okay. Thank you.